Hello friends, today I'll be discussing on a skin condition which resembles psoriasis but not with skin itching. And this skin condition is known as pityriasis lichenoides chronicaerae. So this is understood as PLC. This is a skin condition or a disease that causes the development of small scaling raised spots or papules on the skin. PLC is relatively a mild form of the disease, pityriasis lichenoides. Now, a person with PLC tends to have multiple episodes of papules on the skin lasting for months or a few years, meaning that the disease is chronic. The papules develop gradually. They first appear pink and scaly and then gradually flatten and become brown in color over a period of weeks or months. Papules at various stages may be present at one point of time. The cause of PLC is unknown, but it is not contagious. There are several theories about the cause of this disease, including that it may be a response by the immune system to an infection or medication. A skin biopsy may be used to confirm this diagnosis. The signs and symptoms of PLC include the development of papules on the skin. Now, the papules typically begins as a small firm pink spots and they may have a scaly layer on the top. Over time, the papules typically turn brown in color and eventually fade. The most common locations for the papules are the trunk, buttocks, arms, and the legs. Rarely, these papules may also appear on the hands, feet, face, and the scalp. The papules typically are located in groups and are generally not painful or itchy. Now, this is an interesting differentiation from psoriasis to PLC. The papules can resemble those associated with psoriasis, chickenpox, or even insect bites. In some cases, people have developed PLC after taking medications such as chemotherapy or hormone replacement therapies. Now, this medication may also increase the risk of developing PLC. There is some evidence that PLC could be caused by the overgrowth of cells of the lymphatic system. PLC could also be caused by a reaction of the immune system against the body's own tissues. However, the cause of PLC may be different for different people with the disease, and the exact cause of the disease need to be determined for each person. PLC is not contagious, as I said, because it cannot be spread by coming in contact with a person who has a skin papules. Now, PLC is not thought to be passed directly from parents to children as well. The development of PLC may be associated with having certain kinds of infections, or maybe that it is caused by the immune system attacking the tissues of the body. In general, autoimmune responses are thought to be caused by a combination of genetic and environmental factors. If the cause of PLC can be determined for a specific person and family members have similar risk factors, they may be even having an increased risk to develop PLC as well. Now, most people with PLC notice that their symptoms improve over time. The exact amount of time that people have symptoms of the disease can vary, but typically the papules are present for several months to a few years. In some cases, the papules may disappear and relapse over time. For people with PLC, Ayurvedic herbal treatment helps to shorten the duration of the disease. So some treatments such as steroids or antibiotics may cause side effects. Rarely, people with PLC may develop a specific type of lymphoma of the skin or the cutaneous lymphoma. Thank you so much for watching my video. I'll be coming with more videos related with psoriasis and other skin conditions.